can turn the world on with a smile. You can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile. What a true girl, and you should know it. Each glance and every little movement you show it.
Love is all around.
No need to fake it.
You can never tell.
Why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the show. Today is Thursday, March 1st. And Mark has 859 days left to serve in his U.S. prison sentence. The daily countdown clock is always at freemark.ca, and that's counting down to his early release date of July 9th, 2014, when we hope he will begin his journey back home after serving 85% of his sentence. That's the earliest you can get out as a federal prisoner if you're on good behavior. So that's what we're looking forward to, and we're getting close to halftime served, halftime left to go. I got a card from Mark a little late. It was sent for Valentine's Day, but it finally showed up. It's another beautiful pop-up card made inside the prison, and it says, "Happy Valentine's Day, Jodie. Love, Mark. Your boo." And what's really beautiful about this is the edging on the corner. It's been cut little arrows that have been folded into each other, so it's made a beautiful weave pattern, and the artwork, of course, is beautiful too. So thank you to my sweet Prince Mark, who had this sent to me to bring a smile to my face. And I got to see Mark too 2 weeks ago, I think it was now. I went down to visit him again, and we got to have photos taken together on both days. So we took 5 photos on Saturday and 5 photos on Sunday, and he's mailing those to me as soon as he gets them. So of course, as always, I'll share them here with you. Compared to Mark, I am so super pale though. We got to look at the pictures on the camera as they were taken, but he has certainly been getting out into the sun, making sure to enjoy the fresh air, and the it is very fresh air down there, actually. He said it's very clear and beautiful, and today even is like a summer day for him, so at least he's healthy as he is right now, and I'm so grateful for that. So Mark played in a concert that weekend too, in between my visits. He listed the songs that he played in a blog that I'm going to post tonight, so be sure to check out cannabisculture.com and freemark.ca to read Mark's blog about what he's been up to lately. It's been a while since he's written an update from prison, so I'm sure you all look forward to hearing how he's been spending his time and what he's thinking about and doing, so be sure to check that out later on today and anytime from this point on. After I visited Mark, I traveled on the East Coast. As you know, I've been telling everyone about it, and my last show was done from New Hampshire. But first, I flew into Boston, Massachusetts, where I was treated to a wonderful dinner with a bunch of activists in the area. I really want to thank you all, DJ Slim and Mike Can and everybody who came out to see me. I got to go to Harvard for a night, and we were on the campus grounds there, and I actually got to stand where George Washington rallied the troops. So that sort of history is really fascinating, especially being on the West Coast, where we don't have anything nearly that old out here. So it was such a treat to be shown around for the day I spent in Boston, and also amazing to be told that it was decriminalized there, so nobody even feared the police. They don't even have to give their real name if they get a ticket for $100 for possession. So it was pretty phenomenal to be down there in the United States, where there's people who are saying, yeah, it's decriminalized here, and I had to say, yeah, it's not like that in Canada, so we've got some work to do up here, that's for sure. But congrats to everyone down there who's made that happen. I also got to visit people in Warwick, Rhode Island, a nice dinner there as well with a number of folks coming out, including Dan Davidson, who made the Sweet Leaf guitar that you've seen Tommy Chong jam on, and Mark also jamming on there. They each got a guitar from Dan, so I got to meet him, shake his hand, say hello, and you can see some photos, of course, on Facebook of these dinners and everybody that I met up with. So thank you to everyone in Rhode Island as well for a nice day trip out there. I got to go to the beach, and it was pretty cold, but I'm sure it's just gorgeous in the summer. And then we headed up to Nashville, New Hampshire, where Catherine Leach and her husband were my hosts to drive me around, and they're from Rhode Island. But we went to the New Hampshire Liberty Forum, where I was scheduled to speak. And we met up with some people down there too. We had another dinner out on the town. It's a nice little town for sure. It gets boring pretty fast, but certainly good hospitality there. So it was nice to meet up and enjoy some of the local food and some friends again. And my speech went fairly well. I spoke on Saturday, and a room was packed with about 70 people or so. And when I asked them who knew of MARC Emery, almost every single person put their hand up. So I was grateful to not have to explain who he is and how he's known now. And instead, I explained to all of them most of his activism in the early days was civil disobedience and fighting against taxes and all sorts of other great things that MARC has done before. So I spoke about MARC, I spoke about pot and prohibition and Canada and the US and all sorts of interesting things. And I think it went fairly well, and people told me afterwards they really enjoyed it. Somebody said it was the best speech of the whole event, and it was really great to get such kind words from everyone who was there. So thank you to the New Hampshire Liberty Forum for flying me out and putting me up. It was really excellent to spend some time on the East Coast and to meet some people who are also fighting for liberty. That was just a blast, so thanks again. And you can, of course, watch my Facebook page for some updates and photos and all that there. News in Canada, speaking of how we're going backwards and the U.S. has a lot of progress, the crime bill, the mandatory minimums for marijuana and all these horrible things we've been talking about in the last few months have passed through the Senate with a few amendments to other parts not related to marijuana, but this is an omnibus bill, which means it's like 9 different laws all packed together, and the one that we're most concerned about, of course, is the mandatory minimums for marijuana. But unfortunately, that hasn't been changed despite the efforts of people campaigning against it. Harper and the Conservatives do control the Senate and the House of Commons, and they are limiting debate time. They're limiting all the discussion. They're doing everything they can to push this through. So it's heading back to the House of Commons, but you can still let politicians know how you feel, because when they get responses from our side, it backs them up, because they're being told lies and propaganda from the prohibitionists. So it's really important, even if you can't change their mind or you can't make a difference in respect to this law, just send your support and let them know what you believe in and what other Canadians believe in, and remind them that they're hired by you to try and make a difference to what you want. So make an effort to go to leadnow.ca if you're Canadian. There are a number of different issues going on. For example, our federal government has been connected to some phone calls that went out during the election on voting day, telling Canadians that their voting station had changed when it hadn't. And this is illegal in Canada. You can't do that. You can't tell people the wrong voting station under the guise of, you know, Elections Canada. So there's an investigation going on, but we all knew the Conservatives stole the election. They're sleazy, slimy tricksters anyway, and there's a lot of evidence to point to that over the last few years. So that's some big news, and at leadnow.ca you'll also find a way to shout out about that. So get involved whatever ways you can. It can be discouraging, but when we have any avenues available, we've got to take them. So do what you can. I've signed petitions, I'm doing this as much as possible, and that's all we can really do instead of giving up. I have 2 hoodies I'm going to be giving away this show as my giveaways. Last week I was down in New Hampshire, so if you watched my video, I mentioned that I couldn't do the draw, but this time I have over 90 entries for 2 weeks worth of people watching the shows and entering. And I have them all here in this big silver bag, all the emails from people who entered. I've been mixing it up pretty good, so I'm going to draw 2 people, and I did also say I was going to give a free prize, an extra giveaway for being late. So first I'll do the 2 hoodies, and then I'll announce the other prize. First winner is going to be Robert G., and he wrote a really nice message saying, hoping MARC is the next one to get home on a plane. Your courage is awesome. I'm pushing for our leaders down here to throw us a big sign of respect. And it goes on. So that's 1 winner, Robert G. I'll send you an email. And the next one will be, let's see here, Graham B. I've been slacking on writing a letter. Oh, to MARC. I think he was going to write a letter to MARC. So Graham, thank you for entering. You two are both going to get a free MARC hooded sweatshirt, super soft, super cozy. We'll be shipping that out with some free MARC stickers as well. I always send out all the different free MARC stickers for you to put on your laptop or your skateboard or your locker or wherever, on a cop car. No, don't put it on a cop car, but make good use of a sticker. Put it somewhere where it can be seen. And The third winner, I'm going to give you a union DVD. How about that? I ran into the director of the union, the business behind Getting High, and he's working on part two right now. So maybe it's perfectly fitting that I draw a winner to get a copy of the union DVD. I can sign it for you if you want. I'll send you an email and get your address and ask you about that. But Mark is in the movie and a lot of other locals, and I think it's the number one pot documentary out there. Many others would agree. So I'll send that to a third winner, and you can also watch the union free online now, thanks to the directors putting it out there. They think the information should be available to anyone, and so they put it online for you to watch. I'll include the link in the information below so you can check that out and support the union, guys. So the third winner, the one getting the union, is going to be Lyndon W. And you wanted the free MARC shirt, but you're going to be getting the DVD and some stickers as well. So that's this show's prize giveaway next week. I'm going to stick with another hoodie. I know it's really comfortable and cozy, and people do seem to love them. If you guys have any suggestions of what kind of prizes you'd like to give me to give away, let me know in the comments. I have to tell you, though, that it can't be glass. Unfortunately, we don't send bongs or pipes down across the border, but maybe a vaporizer, maybe some books or DVDs. I don't know. You tell me what you'd like me to give away, and I'll take that into consideration. Thanks a lot for watching, as always. I'll be back next week with another show. Check out cannabisculture.com and cannabisculture.com/store. See what we have online available to buy. And remember that shipping is always free in North America, and we've always got some sort of deal going on, so be sure to check it out. Thanks a lot. Send Mark a note, freemark.ca, as always. And thanks for tuning in.